Can you close that pocket door? Okay. Here we go. Okay. And we're live, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our fourth or fifth recital of COVID via Zoom, via YouTube, out there streaming in the land. This week's recital's theme is singer-songwriter. So you'll be hearing songs by the Beatles, Billy Joel, Elton John, and newer people like Ed Sheeran, Adele, and other really famous singers out there, Jack Johnson, amongst others. So sit back and relax and enjoy our singer-songwriter recital. We are starting out with a pro. This is Miss Ellie Gotch. Take it away, Ellie.
The first song I will be singing today is called Vincent, and it is inspired by Vincent by John McLean. It's inspired by the painter Vincent van Gogh, who throughout my life has been a great source of inspiration. And I find that this song in particular was more of the mindset of the author of the song reaching out to the idea of Vincent if he were still alive and trying to soothe his soul. Because as many people know, Vincent van Gogh did not have an easy life, especially as a painter, and was nowhere near being famous until way after he was dead. And so today I will sing for a lot of lost singers and artists that have not been appreciated. Or I stall for a couple moments as my mother is entering.
She made it there. Wait.
So we're just gonna wait. This particular artist is also important because throughout my life and some of my siblings, we've had the opportunity to create Vincent van Gogh inspired paintings, although I could not find any to show. I hope you like the song.
To say to me how you saw
to set them free, they would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now, for they could not love you. But still your love was true. Singing is a far happier tune and with far younger memories for me. I'm singing Yellow Submarine by the Beatles, which I have a fond memory of singing with my entire class in first grade, along with some with where I've met some of my very best friends. And I hope if they listen to this, they'll get reminded of an entirely silly, goofy recital. But fun memories of meeting each other.
Use it.
Yay! Woo! Thank you, Ellie. And thank you for your backup dinosaur and your, you know, wonderful kazoo playing. That was great. I can always count on you to make it something theatrical. Wonderful. And next up is your lovely sister, Miss Jenny. Take it away, Jenny.
Hello. Make sure it's awake. Oh, so my first song is my Beatles song, and it's not as well known as The Lovely Yellow Submarine. It's called I've Just Seen a Face, and the first time I ever heard it, it was from the Across the Universe movie, and it's where the two young lovers meet and, you know, begin their falling in love. So I think it's a very cute, happy, sweet song, and so thought it would be very fun to sing. I've just seen her face, I can't forget the time or place where we just met. She's just the girl for me, I want all the world to see we met. Had it been another day, I might look the other way, and I'd have never been aware. But as it is, I'll dream of her tonight. Da 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 da. Falling, yes, I'm falling, and she's calling me back again. I have never known the like of this. I've been alone and I have missed things and kept out of sight. But other girls were never quite like this. Da 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 da. Falling, yes, I'm falling, and she's calling me back again. She's calling me back again. I've just seen a face, I can't forget the time or place where we just met. She's just the girl for me, I want all the world to see we met. Da 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 da. Falling, yes I'm falling, and she's calling me back again. Falling, yes I'm falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Falling, yes, I'm falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Whew. Okay, so now, as Carl likes to say, for something completely different. So, my next song was written by Sarah Bareilles, and instead of being one of her pop things or one that she wrote for herself, it's actually one that she wrote for a musical. Because, of course, if I'm going to pick a song and I have a choice, I'm going to pick a musical. So it's one that if you look up the show that it's from, which is Waitress, you will probably find this song as, you know, one of the most well-known songs from it, because it's the big emotional 11 o'clock number that she, you know, sings at the end when she's in a very, you know, low, sad place, and she's singing to, or about her younger self, really. And I always felt like it was something that a lot of people could relate to, and so I wanted to challenge myself to, you know, do something that was very theatrical and emotional, and It's a challenging song, so I was having fun with it, and hopefully you enjoy it. It's not simple to say. Most days I don't recognize me with these shoes and this apron. That place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true I was never attention's sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is most of the time. She's all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. And it's not what I asked for. Sometimes life just slips in through a back door and carves out a person and makes you believe it's all true. And now I've got you, and you're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and bring. Girl that I knew will be reckless just enough, who get hurt, but who learns how to toughen up when she's bruised and gets used by a man who can't love. And then she'll get stuck and be scared of the life that's inside her, growing stronger each day, till it finally reminds her to fight just a little, to bring back the fire in her eyes that's been gone but used to be mine. Used to be mine. Time she's all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine.
Thank you, Jenny. Wonderful job. Thank you so much. Beautiful, moving, and passionate. All right, our next wonderful singer is Miss Monica Davalos. All right, take it away, Monica. What are you going to sing for us today? Got to unmute, kiddo.
Yeah. All right. Hi, I'm Monica, and today I'm going to sing a song from the Beatles, which is what my late grandmother's favorite musical group. So That's exciting. The song I'm going to be singing is Penny Lane, and it's about basically things that happen on this like street or corner, like in the little neighborhood, and like they're like all like saying people are like people have different perspectives on other people and stuff like that. So I will be singing Penny Lane. Showing photographs of every head he had the pleasure to know, and all the people that come and go, stop and say hello. On a corner is a banker with a motor car, the little children laugh at him behind his back, and the banker never wears a mask in the pouring rain. Very strange. Penny Lane. Of the queen, he likes to keep his fire engine clean. It's a clean machine. Lane is in my ears and in my eyes. Up in the blue suburban skies, I sit and meanwhile back behind the shelter in the middle of the roundabout. A pretty nurse is selling poppies from a tray, and all she feels that she's in a play. She is anyway. On the corner, banker shaves another customer. We see the banker sitting waiting for a trend, and then the fireman rushes in from the pouring rain and change. My second song is by Christina Perry. She, I'm pretty sure, is one of the newer singer-songwriters. And she's always been one of my favorite singers just in general. I've always liked her music, and recently I've been listening to more, especially this song. And this is Jar of Hearts, and it's about basically a man going around breaking women's hearts, and she's not going to allow him to do that to her. So this is Jar of Hearts. I know I can't take one more step towards you, 'cause all that's waiting is regret. And don't you know I'm not your ghost anymore? I lost the love I love the most. I've learned to live half a life, and now you want me one more time. And who do you think you are? Run around, leave the scars, collecting your jar of hearts. You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul, so don't come back for me. Ooh. I hear you asking all around if I am anywhere to be found. But I have grown too strong to ever fall back into your arms. I've learned to live half alive, and now you want me one more time. And who do you think you are? What really disguise? Collecting your jar of hearts, tearing love apart. You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul. So don't come back for me. Who do you think you are? It takes so long just to feel alright. Remembering how to put back the light in my eyes. I wish I had missed the first time that we kissed. 'Cause you've broken your promises, and now you're back. You'll be able to get me back. And who do you think you are? Run around, leave your scars, collecting your jar of hearts, tearing love apart. You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul. So don't come back for me. Who do you think you are? It's like lifting your jar of hearts. You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul. So don't come back for me. Don't come back
Monica. Good recovery. Nice work. All right. Thank you very much. Our next singer is Miss Chloe Vidrio. Chloe, what are you going to sing for us today? And tell us about your songs.
Hello. So I'm singing Eleanor Rigby for my first song. I didn't know what this song was about. So Wikipedia says that the song is about in a graveyard in Liverpool lies a headstone bearing the name Eleanor Rigby, often described as a lament for lonely and or the commentary of life in post-war Britain. It tells a story of a woman who died in a church and was buried along with her name. And this song is to remind people to see people who feel unheard.
Oh, look at all the lonely people. Ah, look at all the lonely people. Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice in the church where a wedding has been. Lives in a dream, waits at a window, wearing the face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for, all the lonely people? Where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Mackenzie writing the words of a sermon that no one will hear. No one comes near, look at him working, darning the socks in the night when there's nobody there. What does he care, all the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Eleanor Rigby died in the church and was buried along with her name. Nobody came, Father Mackenzie, wiping the dirt from his hands as he walks from the grave. No one was saved, all the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong?
Disconnected.
Yeah.
All right then, nice work.
Katie's iPhone wanted to just make a statement. Okay. For my second song, I'm singing When We Were Young. And this song is about Adele, who thinks, she's the one who wrote it. So Adele is feeling sad and about when she was young and the people that she misses. Everybody loves the things you do, from the way you talk to the way you move. Everybody here is watching you, 'cause you feel like home, you're like a dream come true. But if by chance you're here alone, can I have a moment before I go? 'Cause I've been by myself all night long, hoping you're someone I used to know. You look like a movie. You sound like a soul. My God, this reminds me of when we were young. Let me photograph you in this light in case it is the last time that we might be exactly like we were before we realized we were sad of getting old. It made us restless. It was just like a movie. It was just like a song. I was so scared to face my fears. Nobody told me that you'd be here. And I swear you moved overseas. And that's what you said when you left me. You still look like a movie. You still sound like a song. My God, this reminds me of when we were young. Let me photograph you in this light in case it is the last time that we might be exactly like we were before we realized we were sad of getting old. It made us restless. It was just like a movie. It was just like a song. When we were young, when we were young, when we were young, when we were young. It's hard to admit that everything just takes me back to when you were there, to when you were there. And a part of me keeps holding on just in case it hasn't gone. Yes, I still care. Do you still care? It was just like a movie. It was just like a song. My God, this reminds me of when we were young.
exactly right. Be exactly like we were before we realized we were sad of getting old. It made us restless. Oh, I'm so mad I'm getting old. It makes me reckless. It was just like a movie. It was just like a song when we realized.
Nice work, Chloe. Thank you.
Thank you.
Our next singer is Mr. David Rodriguez, and he gets the joy of singing along with a special guest there. I think you should introduce him, David.
Yeah, this is my dad, Eric. I'm David, and we're going to be singing Angel by Jack Johnson. And when I hear the song and I read the lyrics, it makes me think about Jack Johnson's family, since he has a wife and three kids, and he thinks of them as angels. So I hope you enjoy this song. Got an angel, she doesn't wear any wings. She wears a heart that can melt my own. She wears a smile that can make me wanna sing. She gives me presents with her presence alone. She gives me everything I could wish for. She gives me kisses on the lips just for coming home. She can make angels, seen it with my own eyes. You gotta be careful when you got good luck, cause them angels will just keep on multiplying. But you're so busy changing the world. Just one smile and you could change all of mine. Share the same soul, whoa. Share the same soul, whoa. Share the same soul, whoa. Whoa. Thank you. Now, it's me. And now I'll be singing another Beatles song. This one is called I Saw Her Standing There. And I just love the tune. I've heard it for many years. And yeah, I hope you enjoy. One second. Technical difficulties. Okay, it should work now. Seems that we have problems.
Did the Bluetooth disconnect or what happened?
Yeah, I think it disconnected.
Okay, so you just need to reconnect it. Do you know how to do that? You go to your settings on your phone and go to Bluetooth, and that should turn it back on again.
Let's see.
Got it?
I don't think so.
So is the unit still on? You might just have to play it from your phone.
It's to work now, or if not, we might need a bill on it.
Oh, that would be unfortunate. I mean, if anything, you could always just play it from your phone.
Yeah, I think we might need a bill from it.
How come?
Let's see.
Just go ahead and play it from your phone.
Yeah, I think that's the best option. Yeah, I think, yeah, we're gonna have to go off with it. All right. No biggie.
It just make sure it's turned all the way up.
Yeah. It's okay.
All right.
Well, she was just 17, if you know what I mean. And the way she looked was way beyond compare. So how could I dance with another? Oh, as I saw her standing there. Well, she looked at me, and I could see that before too long I fell in love with her. Now how could I dance with another? Oh, as I saw her standing there. Well, my heart went boom when I crossed the room and I held her. So we danced through the night, and we held each other tight, and before too long I fell in love with her. Now how could I dance with another? Oh, as I saw her standing there. Yeah. Well, my heart went boom when I crossed the room and I held her hand in my ear. Well, we danced through the night and we held each other tight, and before too long I fell in love with her. Now I'll never dance with another. Oh, as I saw her standing there. Since I saw her standing there. Since I saw her standing there.
Woohoo! Nice work! We're so glad that you figured out a way to make it work, David. Great job. All right, our next singer today is Miss Channing Seifer. Channing, what songs are you going to sing for us today, my dear?
Okay, so, sorry, let me get that out of the way. My first song is called Music Box by Regina Spektor. And it's kind of more like a silly song, but it has a really kind of like important underlying like meaning. And what I think it kind of means is like, she's kind of explaining how the like music industry works and like how she's in it, and like just kind of how, well, you'll see what it means, but it's like or you see what like the lyrics are, but it's like kind of like she dips her tongue into like the music business and like kind of testing it out, and it's a little bit, well, it's hard to explain without you knowing the lyrics, but you'll see. Okay. inside the music box ain't easy. The mallets hit the gears are always turning. And everyone inside the mechanism is yearning to get out and sing another melody completely, so different from the one they're always singing. I close my eyes and think that I have found me, and then I feel mortality surround me. I want to sing another melody, so different from the one I always sing. But when I do the dishes, I run the water very, 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 very hot. And then I slip soap. And then I set all the bottle caps I own afloat. And it's the greatest voyage in the history of plastic. And then I stick my hands in and start to make waves. And then I dip my tongue in and take a taste. It tastes like soap, but it doesn't really taste like soap. And then I lower my whole mouth and take a gulp and start to feel mortality surround me. I close my eyes and think that I have found me. But life inside the music box ain't easy. The mallets hit, the gears are always turning. And everyone inside the mechanism is yearning to get out and sing another melody completely, is yearning to get out, is yearning to get out, is yearning to get out. Thank you. And my next song is Goodbye Yellow Brick Road by Elton John and Bernie Taupin. And this song, it kind of connects to my first song because I originally thought it was also about the music business, which I guess it could be. But now that I start to sing it more and like listen to the lyrics, I kind of understand that it's about the music business, but it's also about Elton John's journey throughout like his life and how he's treated for being who he is, like his sexuality when he came out, and kind of how he wants to get away from all the negativity that comes with that. So wait.
When are you gonna come down? When are you going to land? I should have stayed on the farm. I should have listened to my old man. You know you can't hold me forever. I didn't sign up with you. I'm not a present for your friends to open. This boy's too young to be singing the blues. Ah, ah. So goodbye, yellow brick road, where the dogs of society howl. You can't plant me in your penthouse. I'm going back to my plow, back to the howling old owl in the woods, hunting the horny-backed toad. Oh, I finally decided my future lies beyond the yellow brick road. Shoot down your plane. It'll take you a couple of vodka and tonics to set you on your feet again. maybe you'll get a replacement. There's plenty like me to be found. Mongrels who ain't got a penny, singing for Tibbetts like you on the ground. Can't plant me in your penthouse. I'm going back to my plow, back to the howling old owl in the woods, hunting the horny back toad. Oh, I finally decided my future lies beyond the yellow brick road.
Oh, I just realized that I was muted. Great job. Thank you, Channing. Beautiful work. All right, Ms. Vivian May, you are up next. And what are you going to sing for us? Oop. Are you there? Uh-oh. Vivian? There she is. We lost you for a minute there.
Yeah, it just started.
Of course it did. So what are you gonna sing for us today, Miss Vivian?
So my first song I found through watching one of my favorite shows, Gilmore Girls, and this is the theme song, and I was like, hey, I wonder if that song would work for the recital, and it did. So it was becoming the theme song for the Gilmore Girls show. I don't know how many people know that show, but it is a very mother-daughter relationship, how they are best friends, but then it's also just their relationship, I guess. But yeah.
Need me to be with you, I will follow where you lead.
Okay, and my second song is yet another Beatles song, Across the Universe, and it is kind of what I think of as an organized chaos inside someone's head, all their thoughts just mixing together, but it's still, I don't know, creative and just different things happening, I guess, if that's a good way to explain it.
Words are flying out like endless rain into a paper cup. They slither while they pass, they slip away across the universe. Pools of sorrow, waves of joy are drifting through my open mind, possessing and caressing me.
Vivian, thank you. Did you get new contacts also? I don't think I've ever seen you without your glasses. It's beautiful. All right. Next up, we have Mr. Mark Yonaba with some very fun songs that he has been working very hard on. Tell us all about it.
Hello. Well, I just introduced by saying last Sunday I told a friend who has Baroque and classical tastes. Don't mind that. I told a friend who has Baroque and classical tastes about the recital, but I cautioned him that I would be singing pop songs. And he said someone once told him, "Oh, I love all music from classical to modern, from Frank Sinatra to Lady Gaga." So by that standard, Carole King started her songwriting career in the classical era, writing the number one hit Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow with her husband Jerry Goffin in 1960 for the Shirelles, a women's group. And Carol wrote an astonishing array of other pop hits throughout the 60s, but her singing career really started later, taking off with a bang with her 1971 Grammy-winning album Tapestry. My first song is her 72 hit, Canaan. In it, she reminisces about a beautiful land that she's left behind while she's living in LA, but it's been hard for me to tell exactly where her metaphorical Canaan was, or if indeed she had even found it yet when she wrote this song. Though by the late 70s, she had left LA for rural Idaho, where she still lives today. So here, if I can get it to work, I have to turn my speaker back on. Come on, speaker.
Battery 100%. Connected to...
There we go. Okay, here is Canaan. Green fields and rolling hills, room enough to do what we will. Sweet dreams of yestertime are running through my mind of a place I left behind. Been so long, I can't remember when. I've been to Canaan and I wanna go back again. Been so long, I'm living till then. 'Cause I've been to Canaan and I won't rest until I go back. Sometimes I long to be somewhere else. I try to do what I can. So with our day-to-day demands, we all need a promised land. Been so long, I can't remember when. I've been to Canaan and I want to go back again. Been so long, I'm living till then. 'Cause I've been to Canaan and I won't rest until I go back. Oh, I want to be there in the winter time, with a fireplace burning to warm me, and you to hold me when it's stormy. Been so long, I can't remember. I've been to Canaan and I want to go back again. Been so long, I'm living till then. 'Cause I've been to Canaan and I won't rest until I go back again. I've been to Canaan and I won't rest until I go back again. Stop. Technology. I've always had a soft spot for a cappella music, from classical to modern and pop, and so I just loved Billy Joel's 1983 a cappella hit The Longest Time from the moment I first heard it. Although at that time I thought it was much older and I thought Johnny Mathis was singing it, it seems the song was part of an homage album to musical influences of Billy Joel's early life. I was especially intrigued when I learned years later that Billy Joel had recorded all the tracks on the piece, both the lead and the backup voices. Fool that I am, I said, I could do that. Fooling around with the Audacity sound mixing software, which for those interested is free open source software, and with stubbornness and a huge amount of work, I came up with this rendition of The Longest Time. See if I can get that. One, two, three, four. Dum, dum, dum.
Whoa,
longest
for the longest time. Whoa,
longest
for the longest if you said goodbye to me tonight.
There
would still be left to right. What else would I do? I'm so inspired by you. That hasn't happened for the longest time. Once I thought my innocence was gone. Now I know that happiness goes on. That's where you found me when you put your I haven't been there for the longest time. Whoa,
longest
for the longest time. Whoa,
longest
for the longest time. That voice you're hearing in the hall. And the greatest miracle of all is how I need. How you needed me to. That hasn't happened for the longest time. Hoon, last very long. But you feel so right, and I could be wrong. Maybe I've been hoping too hard, but I've gone this far, and it's more than I hoped for. Who knows how much further we'll go on? Maybe I'll be sorry when you're gone. I'll take my chances. I forgot how nice romance is. I haven't been there for the longest time. I had second thoughts at the start. I said to myself, hold on to your heart. Now I know the woman that you are. You're wonderful so far, and it's more than I hoped for. I don't care what consequence it brings. I have been a fool for lesser things. I want you so bad. I think you ought to know that I intend to hold you for the longest time. Whoa,
longest
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 for the longest time.
Woohoo! Mark and the Four Marks. Great work. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, our final singer today, Miss Celeste Hanasek. Cannot wait to hear what you have to share with us. Getting back from the Bahamas with your tan. Nice.
It's better in person, I promise, guys. Okay, so the first song that I'm going to sing for you guys is I Choose You by Sarah Bareilles. And this is a really sweet song. And I appreciate, so basically she says, I choose you over and over again. But there's one part, hold up, let me grab it. Where did it go? Okay, so she says, we are not perfect, we'll learn from our mistakes, and as long as it takes, I will prove my love to you. I am not scared of the elements, I am underprepared, but I am willing, and even better, I get to be the other half of you. And I appreciate, I just think it's super sweet, and it's like, I chose you, and I love you, so like, maybe you can choose me, you know? Anyway, this is I Choose You.
Bow break, let it come down crashing. Let the sun fade out to a dark sky. I can't say I'd even notice it was absent, 'cause I could live by the light in your eyes. I'll unfold before you strung together, the very first words of a lifelong love letter. Tell the world that we finally got it all right. I choose you. I will become yours and you will become mine. I choose you.
My next song is Elton John. It's Your Song. And this one I just love. It's so sweet and it reminds me of my little sister. I don't know. I just The first time I sang it to her with her in mind, and so that's how I sing it from, like, now on, I guess. Okay. Your Song by Elton John. So much for sharing your amazing gifts today and for working so hard on these songs. I will look forward to seeing all of you next week.
I've tried doing an applause thing before. Unfortunately, it doesn't work. Apparently, it's always just me sitting there clapping my hands on YouTube. So, yay for all of you. You can give yourselves a round of applause. Wonderful work. And I will look forward to seeing you all out in YouTube land at the June 12th recital. I will see all of you students at your lessons next week.